Amen. What a blessing it is to be back in the Lord's house.
Amen.
Again tonight, amen, we thank God for each and every one that has come out to be with us tonight. And we hope and pray tonight that Lord have his way in everything that is said and done. Amen, that we might walk out here saying that it's been good to be in the house of the Lord. Amen, amen. We pray tonight that God will have his way in everything that is said and done tonight. And to be honest with you, I don't know where I'm at. I don't know where I'm at, but and that's a weird feeling to have, standing up here, amen. And let's pray, amen. Let's pray tonight. Ask God, amen. Father, dear Lord, it's again God that we come to you tonight with humble hearts, thanking you, Lord, for this day. Thanking you, Father, God, for loving us, Lord, as we come to you tonight, God, as simple as we know how. Father, we pray tonight, Lord, that above everything else, God, that your will, Lord, would be done. Father, Lord, that you would lead us and guide us and direct us, Lord, Father, in the ways, God, that you would have us to go. Father, we don't want to do anything, Lord, less than that you're in the midst of it. God, we ask you tonight, Lord, that you would lead us and guide us, Lord. Father, we pray tonight, Lord, if we've done or said anything this week, Lord, that would affect this service in any way, Father, that you would forgive us of it. Lord, pull us up. God, make preaching or teaching easy tonight. Father, how we love you tonight, God, because you first loved us. And Father, we pray tonight, Lord, to have your way in everything, God, that is said and done. And Father, whatever's accomplished, Lord, will not fail. God, to bow our head, and Lord, to give you the praise and the honor and the glory. Father, for we ask it all in Jesus' holy and precious name, we do pray. And amen. And amen. And again, we'd like to say we thank the Lord, amen, for each and every one that has come out tonight. Amen. And you pray tonight that God will have his way, amen, in everything that you said and done. If, amen.
Lord help.
Thank you, Lord.
If you got your Bibles, let's go to the book of Acts tonight again. Amen. In chapter number 7. Amen. And I want to read to you a few verses of scripture, amen, and then we'll take a little thought, amen, and see what the Lord has in store, amen. And so you pray hard tonight, amen. But in Acts chapter number 7, amen, down in verse number 51, amen, want to read to you, amen, out of the Word of God. Amen. To be honest with you, this might be all we do. Amen. It's just read. Amen. Because I don't want to do anything. God ain't in it. Amen. And if the Lord said go home, guess what? We're going to talk about that. Amen. So, verse number 51. This was Stephen. Amen. And he was beginning to preach a message. As everybody knows, he was one of the deacons. Amen. One of the seven that was appointed after the church had started, amen. And here he began to preach a message, amen. And boy, I'm telling you, you think sometimes I get down where rubber meets the road. You wait till you hear about this dude, amen. Amen. He'll make me seem like a real tender-hearted, nice kind of guy, amen. But he starts out in 51. He said, "You stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart and ears, do always resist the Holy Ghost as your fathers did, so do you. Amen. Which of the prophets have not your fathers persecuted, and they have slain them which shewed before of the coming of the just one, of whom you have been now the betrayers and murderers, who have received the law
by the disposition of angels and have not kept you. When they heard these things, they were cut to the heart, and they gashed on him with their teeth. But he, being full of the Holy Ghost, looked up steadfastly in the heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing on the right hand of God, and said, Behold, I see the heavens open and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of God. And they cried with a loud voice and stopped their ears and ran upon him with one accord and cast him out of the city and stoned him. And the witness laid down their clothes at a young man's feet, whose name was Saul. Amen. And they stoned Stephen, calling upon God and saying, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. And he knelt down and he cried with a loud voice, Lord, lay not this sin to their charge. And when he had said this, he fell asleep. Amen. Now, if you got your Bibles, I want you to go over in the book of Galatians, amen, in chapter number 6, amen, down in verse number 14, amen, and want you to listen. It says, but God forbid. Now, this is Paul talking, amen, that was Saul that we just read about in the book of Acts, amen. And he said, but God forbid that I should glory save in the cross our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom the world is crucified unto me, and I unto the world. Amen. In other words, he had died out to the world. Amen. And if we had a thought to lay upon this just for a little while tonight, I would like to use for a thought, is there stood a cross. Amen. There stood a cross. Amen. And as we look at the beginning of the church age, amen, over in the book of Acts, amen, it was all about the cross. Amen. It was about the one that died upon the cross. Amen. And as we begin to look, and as the church began to blossom and it began to grow, amen, they picked out these 7 individuals that was full of the Holy Ghost of God. Amen. And the only thing that had made the difference in their life was the cross. Amen. And the only thing that will make a difference in our life is the cross. Amen. Of the Lord and Savior Jesus. Amen. Christ. Amen. It ain't the old wooden tree. Amen. But it's the one that hung upon the wooden tree. Amen. 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 And so I'd like to say tonight, amen, that in our world and in our society, amen, and in this generation that we live in, amen, what makes the difference and what is the dividing line in this old world is the cross. Amen. Boy, I tell you, we still got people in this world today that oppose the cross. Amen. Yeah. They oppose the blood of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So you might say tonight that the cross is a dividing line. Amen. Between evil and between good. Amen. And right there in the middle hung Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord of lords and King of kings. He's the only one that can make a difference in our life. Amen. And boy, I tell you, it's the reason that Paul said, he said, if I glory in anything, let me glory in the cross. Amen. Because Paul knew and he realized it was because of the cross and what happened on the cross. Amen. That made the difference in his life. Amen. They said, and it'll make the difference in your life. And it'll make the difference in the way that you walk, in the way that you think, in the way that you talk. It'll separate you from the rest of the world. Amen. We read over here in the book of John that we read and last night. He said, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. And if a man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. Now, let me clarify, just for a little bit, what this is talking about. Amen. It ain't a talking about the world that we live in today. Amen. It's not talking about the trees that puts out their buds and brings forth the leaves in the summertime and the grass that grows up. Amen. And the rivers that run. Amen. Tonight, and the oceans, amen, and all the beautiful scenery upon this earth. This is not what this scripture is talking about. See, as God made Adam and Eve a garden, amen, tonight, Brother David, he gave us a world that we might be able to enjoy, amen, and to know and to recognize that he is the creator of everything. Amen. Boy, when it's warm outside of the morning, I love to get up real early. Amen. And get me a hot cup of coffee. Amen. And go out and sit down on the porch and listen to the birds as they begin to sing. And I see the sunrise as it begins to come up. Amen. Knowing in my heart, he is God that created all of these things. Amen. And he created it for you and I to enjoy. And you say, preacher, what is he talking about? And brother, he is talking about the spiritual wickedness of this old world and the people that rebel against the goodness of God. Amen. Tonight, and they shove the cross. We have churches today and it's taken the blood out of the song books. They don't want to hear anything about the cross. Honey, let me tell you tonight, it is the cross that makes the difference in mine and your life tonight.
Amen.
How you live, how you're living your life today, amen, depends on which side of the cross you're on.
Amen.
Amen, because the cross is the divided line. Amen, tonight you see a cross. Amen. And you say, preacher, how? How come? Hey, they could have hung Jesus on the right side. They could have hung Jesus on the left side. But you know where they done it? They hung him in the middle. Amen. 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 Tonight, if there's a reason why he was on that middle cross. Amen. Tonight, because that cross is a divided line. Amen. And boy, on one side, you got the saved and the redeemed. On the other side, you got the lost and the rebellion. Amen. And brother, the only thing that'll make a difference in our life tonight is the cross. Amen. And boy, whenever we glory, if we glory in the cross, amen, that's the reason Hebrews said, he said, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Amen. And tonight I'm glad for the cross of Calvary. I'm glad for what happened there. I'm glad there my sin then was paid forever. And I'm glad, thank God, one night on bending knees, I met the man that hung in the middle. Amen. And he took all of my sins away. And he set me free. And he made me a new creature in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
You want to know why Stephen was able to do what he doing? What compassion and what love this ordinary man had. Amen. Was a deacon in one of the churches. But he was filled with a love. Amen. That was more extreme than any love that you ever see in people today. Amen. Tonight, more people cross our path today. Amen. It takes us a week or a month or two. Amen. To get over it. Amen. Tonight, we want revenge. Amen. Tonight, we want to take it out on them. Amen. But here is a man that is called Stephen. Amen. And the only thing that he was doing, he was preaching about the cross and about what happened on the cross and the sacrifice on the cross. Amen. Tonight, he was telling that if they wanted life, they had to get on the other side of the cross. Amen. And they begin to stone him. And they run upon him. And they begin to bite upon him. And boy, what a death that he had. And they listen tonight. I mean, there is a cross that makes a difference in mine and your life. am I.
Amen.
The devil is after every one of us tonight.
Amen.
You know that?
Amen.
Amen. If you're in here and you're saved tonight by the blood of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, I guarantee you the devil is hot on your tracks.
Amen.
Amen. If a devil ain't bothering you, it's probably because he's already got you. Amen. It's probably because he's already got you exactly where he wants you at, and there ain't no need for him to bother you anymore. Amen. Tonight, but buddy, if you're saved tonight, amen, the old slew foot, he's dead after you. He's looking at every way in the world to destroy you. Amen. He is wanting to eat you up and to spit you out along the side of the road. And there's not but one thing stopping him tonight, and that's the cross. Amen. The cross of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Old devil can do a lot of things. He can cross a lot of places. Amen. Tonight, but you know what string? And down that line, down that cross, on that day of crucifixion, you know what flowed down? The blood. Amen. Tonight, and that blood drew a line. Amen. And whenever Jesus saved me, he put me on the protective side of the bloodline. The old devil might be able to do a lot of things. Under Brother Jimmy, he can't stand the blood of Jesus. Amen. I'm glad tonight. I thank God I'm on the winning side. I'm on the right side of the cross, honey. Listen tonight. The cross will make a difference in your
Amen.
Life tonight.
Amen.
The cross will make a difference. If you talk to a lot of people in the world and in society today, they despise the cross. A lot of our religions and the religious organizations, amen, that we have in our society today don't like anything said about the cross. Amen. Tonight, boy, on the cross is where it all took place.
Amen.
On the cross is where it happened. Don't you realize just because God said that he loved you? Amen. I was talking to somebody the other day, and they said, God wouldn't send me to hell. I said, how do you figure that? He said, God said in John 3:16, for God so loved the world, amen, that he gave his only begotten son. Amen. He loves me, and so he's not going to send me to hell. I said, can you do me a favor? He said, I sure can. I said, look through your Bible, amen, and find me a place in the Word of God where it says love saves you.
Amen.
Love don't save you. Amen. He come and he give his life that we might be saved by his grace.
Amen.
Amen. That if we call upon him, once we call upon him and we get in him and he gets in us, amen, then we're on the right side of the cross.
Amen.
Amen. We're on the winning side of the cross. Amen. Ever since the beginning of the Garden of Eden, when Eve partaken of that fruit, amen, and she gave unto Adam, and they sinned there in the garden. Amen. A warfare ever since. Amen. It's reason in, I think it's in the third chapter of the book of Genesis. Amen. Tonight, where that the Bible says that he shall bruise thy heel, but he said, I will bruise his head. Amen. And he's talking about the struggle. Amen. From Genesis all the way through the Revelation. Amen. A struggle of what? A struggle between good and evil. Amen. A struggle between righteous and lost. Amen. A struggle, thank God, them that is wanting to live right, amen, and them that is doing everything wrong, amen. Tonight, listen tonight, the old devil is wanting to destroy your life. I want to use an example for just a few minutes. If you're on this side of the cross, amen, and on this side of the cross is leading you up to heaven, amen, tonight, and boy, the blood has done already been applied.
Amen.
You've done already been set free. Your name has done already been wrote down in the Lamb's Book of Life. Amen. Tonight there's an evilness on this side of the cross. Amen. Tonight, and what that evilness tries to do, it can't cross the bloodline that come down the cross. Amen. Tonight, but it uses the influences of this world that we live in to tempt us from day to day. That's the reason 1 John said, he said, in the world is the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life. Amen. You know how the devil, amen, got Eve attracted, amen, to that tree. And the first thing that she done, she looked upon it. Amen. Brother, there's sometimes in situations in this life, the best thing we can do is to close our eyes and to back off, amen, and get as far away from the devil as we can, because that power is trying to pull you back. Amen, brother, I'm telling you tonight, and Satan is mightier than anybody you ever want to come up against.
Amen.
There is an evilness in this world that is attacking every saved person that is being born again of the Holy Spirit of God. Now sometimes we'll have a thought. Sometimes we'll look up on something the wrong way. Sometimes we might even slip. And boy, if we're up here, amen, and we begin to slip, the old devil begins to drag us back. Amen, tonight, and as we begin to fall back into this worldly thing, amen, there's a Spirit of God, amen, that holy conviction power of God, and is able to sit down into our life, amen, and able to forgive us of where we have failed. Amen, and help us to regain our balance. Amen. Have you ever failed before? Amen. It seemed like it'd take you 15 minutes to hit the ground. Amen. I was out last week this fall. Amen. I'm working around the house. Amen. And I tripped over a cord where I had my table saw hooked up, and I could feel myself going down. Amen. But there wasn't anything to grab to. Amen. Boy, I was reaching and grabbing for everything, and all at once, hey, he heard like a thump on the ground. Amen. Tonight, listen. That's what the old devil tries to get us to do. He tries to get us to stumble and fall, that he might be able to use his power to pull us back on the other side of the cross. Anybody can't cross the bloodline. And Jesus is there. And whenever we're weak, he is the strongest. Amen. That he ever is in our life. And boy, sometimes the only thing we can do is just to cry out and shout the glory of God, because we're on the winning side of the cross.
Amen.
Stephen's life, the cross is what made the difference. In Paul's life, the cross is what made the difference. In your life tonight, if you're saved, the cross is what makes the difference. You didn't have anything to do with it. You didn't have a thing in the world to do with it. Jesus done it for you.
Amen.
Amen. You say, preacher, I had the faith to believe that he was going to save me. And where did that faith come from?
Amen.
When the Holy Spirit of God brought conviction upon your heart and conviction upon your life, you know what the Holy Spirit done? It gave you the faith to believe that he was who he said he was.
Amen.
Tonight, so it was all Jesus. You couldn't even muster up enough faith to believe that he was God without the Holy Spirit giving you that faith. Amen. So see, it's all about the Lord. Amen. The same. I had a person to tell me one time, said, I've tried two or three times to save myself and it just don't work. I said, I agree with you, and it never will. Amen. Because you can't save yourself. You can't get on the right side of the cross. Amen. Because if you get on the right side of the cross, it's got to be through the blood of the Lord and Savior Jesus' work, the finished product. Amen. When he cried, it is finished, it is done. Amen. It is complete. Amen. Our salvation is done. So why do we love not the things of this world? The Bible says tonight
the things that oppose God, the things that oppose the righteousness of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we need to stay away from. We need to stay just as far away from as we can. I worked a job one time, and some guys know that I was a preacher. And they'd come in every morning, just they'd get around me and cuss and just tell filthy jokes. And I never said anything. And that thing went on for about a week. And they come in there one morning, they started that stuff. I said, you guys need to wait this minute. First of all, I ain't interested in what you're talking about. Second of all, I'm not going to listen to what you're talking about. If you want to talk like that, you go stick your head out the back door and talk all you want to. Find somebody to listen to. But I'm telling you right now, in a very polite way, to get away from me. And to stay out of my way. If you got something to say and you want to say it in the right manner, I'm willing to listen. But you're not talking to me like that. You're not talking around me like that. And I said, this conversation is over. It is done. And I'm done. And boy, you know what? They never did do that anymore. Sometimes we just got to show the world where we're standing. Sometimes we just got to stand up and say, hey, I'm not doing this anymore. I'm not allowed you to do this anymore in my presence. Amen. And boy, I'm telling you, you say, preacher, how in the world you stop? Every time they come to me and say, preacher, I want to tell you something. And they start off on a little bit of that stuff, you know what to do. I put my hand up. They go, whoa. I said, let me tell you something. And they said, what is it you want to tell me? I said, Jesus loved you so much he died up on an old cross. Amen. That he might be able to save you, wash your mouth, give you a brain to think with and a mouth to talk with. And I said, boy, ain't God good. Amen. About two or three trips like that, he cleared everything up. But you got to show the world which side of the cross you stand on.
Amen.
I'm going to ask you tonight, which side of the cross are you on? Has the cross made a difference in your life? Are you standing for what you believe? Are you showing the world what you believe in? Hey, a lot of people don't believe in nothing. A lot of people, they just go with the flow. There's a lot of people that ignore the things of Jesus. So I ask you tonight, amen, in closing, which side of the cross are you on? Are you on the winning side? Are you on the side that has the banner already waving, that you got the victory? Amen. In this man called Jesus Christ. Paul said, if I glory in anything, let me glory in the cross. I've had people all of my life. Was the funeral home one night. A man, I run into a preacher down there, I'm not going to call no name. And he said, I've done this and I've done that and I've done this and I've done that and I've done this and I've done that. And he said, well, God's been so good to me. He said, what all you done? I looked at him. I said, absolutely nothing. He said, you mean tell me you ain't done anything? I said, I ain't done a thing. He said, then how in the world is the church growing like it is? I said, because God done it. I'm just an instrument.
Right.
I'm just a body. Amen. That the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ uses because the cross made the difference. Amen tonight. If you're on the wrong side of the cross, your life is going to be full of trouble, full of heartaches. I went to a county jail here a while back. Seemed like every time somebody gets in jail, they're sorry for everything they ever done, everything they ever thought about doing, and everything that they was going to do the next 150 years. And it is amazing how many people that once they get in behind them iron bars and them iron doors shut, automatically find religion. I got a call, went down and talked to this person. And I talked to them just for about 5 minutes and I realized in my heart they was loster than a hound dog in high weeds. And I told them, I said, I want to tell you something. I said, as long as you lay with dogs, you're always going to have fleas.
Amen.
And they said, well, what do you mean by that? I said, as long as you're in the gutter, you ain't never going to get out. You got to get out of the gutter. You got to want to be out of the gutter more than anybody else wants you out of the gutter. Will God save you? Yeah, He'll save you.
Yeah.
And then you won't want to go back to the gutter. Listen tonight. There's a lot of religious folks in the world today. Religious churches all up and down the road. Religious churches all the way through the community. But have you ever thought and ever wondered how many people are saved? How many people's on the right side of the cross doing the right things? I'll tell you what, if you're on this side of the cross, 9 times out of 10, you'll take the Lord's name in vain. If you're on this side of the cross, you praise Him. Stay cussing.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. It depends on which side of the cross you're on, what kind of attitude you got towards the cross. Amen. The world is on one side. We are on the other.
Thank you, Jesus.
And Jesus is in the middle.
Thank you, Jesus.
Weren't you glad He's in the middle? I'm glad He's in the middle protecting us and keeping us strong even when we're weak. It wasn't Paul that was such a mighty person. It was the cross stood in between him and the enemy. And the one on the cross empowered him to live the life that he was living. That same power is available to you today. I know this thing's been broken. And I apologize, but I feel like I brought you the truth tonight, and the truth will help you. Amen. The truth will help you. One thing about it, I get this if you don't get anything else. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews that He's our anchor. You know what an anchor on a ship does, right? You get out and you put that anchor down in the water and it keeps that boat from drifting. Well, that ain't the kind of anchor Jesus was talking about. Christ says, I am the anchor. If we're on this side of the cross and we're in Him and that anchor is in us, that anchor just keeps pulling us closer to Him. And that anchor just slowly begins to pull us towards the love of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. My, how I thank Him for that tonight. How I thank Him. Amen. For loving me and keeping me safe down through the years. Let's all stand tonight. Amen. By then, you'll have a song. If you're here tonight, you feel like praying, the altar's open. Amen. And I hope and pray that this has made some sense. Amen. That it's helped us tonight to realize, amen, the importance of being on the right side of the cross. Amen. Let Jesus help you tonight. Let God help you tonight. As people's coming together around the altar, there any others tonight? Anyone else like to come and pray? Boy, ain't God good. Amen. We're on the countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Let's pray. Amen. Father, dear Lord, we come to you tonight, God, with humble hearts, thanking you, Lord, for this day, thanking you, God, for loving us. And Lord, we thank you, Father, for the service tonight. God, we pray tonight, Lord, that you would take these broken words tonight, God, and put them back together with the Holy Spirit of God. Father, just help us, Lord, to, Father, that God, he'd be a blessing to someone tonight. Father, how we thank you, Lord, tonight, God, for saving us, being able to keep us, Lord. God, we pray, Father, you just polish us. Lord, help us, God, use us, Lord, in this life. Father, that we might win somebody for Jesus. God, we pray, Lord, for every soul that is in here tonight, souls around the altar, God, that needs, Lord, that they stand in need of. God, we thank you tonight, Lord, for loving us. And Father, how we love you tonight and how we praise you. God, meet the needs, Lord, of these families here tonight. Lord, undertake. God, just have your way, Father, in everything, Lord, that is said and done. Father, whatever's accomplished, dear God, we'll not fail to bow our head, Lord, to give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory. Father, for we ask it all in Jesus' holy and precious name, we do pray and amen.